See, we need to derive equation for refractive index of the prism in this particular session. We already know refractive index using a Snell's law. It is mu is equal to sin I divided by sin r. We have this prism where PQ is the incident light ray, QR is refracted light ray, RS is emergent light ray. Actual path of the light ray is this. Refracted light ray is this, and now we have angle of deviation delta. A, B, C are the vertex of the prism. R1, R2 are refractive index of the R1, R2 are the angle of refractions at surface Q and surface R. Okay, these are the notations which are being notated in this particular diagram. Now, in order to find out the refractive index, we should find out I and R. So, for that, we are now going to some mathematical alterations. We will do some mathematical modifications to these so that we can find out I and R. What we do, first, let me choose a quadrilateral AQDR, which is four sides. As we know that sum of two opposite angles are equal to 180 degrees. For quadrilateral AQDR, opposite angles are A plus D. So A plus D is equal to 180 degrees. That is equation one. And in step two, what I am doing, I am taking this triangle QR and D. From this triangle, sum of three sides should be equal to 180 degrees. Sum of three sides are R1 plus R2 plus D. These three angles should be equal to 180 degrees. That is equation number two. As equation 1 and equation 2, it shows that they are 180 degrees. Therefore, simply you can equate equation 1 and equation 2. That gives you A plus D is equal to R1 plus R2 plus D. D and D gets cancelled. What is left over here? We have got only A, which is equal to R1 plus R2. So we have first got one expression. A is equal to R1 plus R2. So using step 1 and step 2, we have got A is equal to R1 plus R2. That I am considering it as equation number 3. Now coming to step 4. Sorry, step 3. Now let us choose one more triangle. Triangle Q, E and R. Take this triangle Q, E and R, upper triangle, this small one, smaller triangle. So if you take these triangles, sum of these three sides should be equal to 180 degrees, is it not? So sum of those three sides should be equal to 180 degrees. That is I minus R1 plus E minus R2 plus E is equal to 180 degrees. Fine. Right. So students, we have got equation 3 as A is equal to R1 plus R2. Now take the triangle QER. If you take QER, you can use sum of exterior angle is equal to sum of two opposite interior angles. So in this triangle, you can use exterior angle is equal to sum of two opposite interior angles. Exterior angle is delta is equal to sum of two opposite interior angles. It is I minus R1 plus E minus R2. This is equal to I plus E minus of R1 plus R2. Okay. Therefore, delta can be written as I plus E minus of R1 plus R2. Right. But what is R1 plus R2? From equation 3, you can write it as A. Therefore, delta is equal to I plus E minus A. Let me take this as equation number 4. Okay. Next. We have one more step to consider, that is step 4. in the step four, what we are learning is whenever you are under, whenever the light ray is undergoing refraction in this particular prism, at some particular angle, which is called as angle of minimum deviation, so delta, this angle will be minimum if and only if angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence and angle of refractions are equal. So I and E will be equal, then R1 will be equal to R2. When is it possible? It is only possible for angle of minimum deviation. So for angle of minimum deviation, we can write I is equal to E. This is one. And we can also write R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R, where this R is nothing but angle of refraction. So wherever I is there, you can write it with E. Wherever R1 and R2 are there, you can write it as R. Now what to do? You'll use these conclusions in equation number 4. If I use these conclusions in equation number 4, what do you get? Check it up. Delta minimum is equal to 2 times I minus A. And A goes to the other side. Delta M plus A is equal to 2i, and from here you can write angle of incidence is equal to delta m plus a divided by 2. This is equation for angle of incidence. Okay, now next conclusion we have from equation 3. R1 plus R2 is equal to A. But what is R1 and R2? They are equal to R. So it is 2R is equal to A. R is equal to A by 2. This is angle of refraction. We have refractive index formula. Mu is equal to sine angle of incidence divided by sine angle of refraction. We have got equation for I and equation for R. Take this I and R value, substitute in this equation. Mu is equal to sine of, I can be written as delta M plus A divided by 2 by sine of A divided by 2. This is the final expression for finding refractive index of the prism. And this formula you need to remember. We are now plotting graph for angle of deviation and angle of incidence. As we have already learned, this is angle of incidence I. And this is angle of emergent E. This is angle of deviation delta. Okay. Now you have different angles possible. I can be any angle, like for example, I'll be taking different values for I and you will be getting different E values and also delta. Okay. For example, I value, I'll be choosing different angles. For that, you will be getting different E values and you can even write, you can calculate delta from that. Okay. Now, for example, I can take I as 10 degrees. First angle of incidence, I'll be taking 10 degrees. Next angle of incidence, I can take it as 15 degrees. Next angle of incidence, I can take 20 degrees. Next to 25 degrees. Next to 30 degrees. Next to 35 degrees. Next 40 degrees. Then 45 degrees. Like that, you can change angle of incidence by 5 degrees every time. So you will be using a protractor and you will measure that angle I. You can measure that angle I, angle of incidence. First, you can place it at 10 degrees, then 15, 20, 25, 30, or you can start it with opposite, like you can start it with 60 degrees and then you come back downward like this. You can choose angle of incidence as 70 degrees and then come back to 60 degrees and then decrease to 50 degrees and then decrease to 40 degrees and then decrease to 30 degrees and then 20 degrees and finally take 10 degrees. For different angle of incidence, you will be getting different angle of emergence, right? You'll be getting angle of emergent E. You'll be getting E. and we have got relation for delta. Delta is equal to I plus E minus R1 plus R2. Or you can write delta is equal to I plus E minus A. This is the relation for delta. I value for this particular angle of incidence I, you will be getting some angle of emergence. E value, you will be measuring it with protractor. Okay. So when you measure it with protractor, E values will be different. Fine. Now E value will be different. So that E you can like when you measure it, you will be getting some value. Say for example, you may get it here for 10 degrees, you may get it here as 65 degrees. For 20 degrees, you may get it as 60 degrees. For 30 degrees, you may get it as 54 degrees. And for 40 degrees, you may get it as 45 degrees. And for 50 degrees, you may get it as 55 degrees. For 60 degrees, you may get it as 58 degrees. For 70 degrees, you may get it as 60 degrees. Like these are noted values. For different I values, you may get different E values. You can measure it with protractor. And for your explanation, actually you should do this in experimental way. So for different I values, you are getting different E values. Now check it up. What is your, if you plot graph for this? Let us plot graph for this. It's very simple. Here we are considering E and here we are finding I, right? I'm sorry, here you need to take it as delta. Okay. Now when you take I value, I starts from 0, then 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, like that. I value goes on increases. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. You can take possible angles. For that, you will be getting emergent angles. And from emergent angle, you can substitute that here and you will be getting delta, angle of deviations. So angle of deviation also here we are choosing it. Okay, it can be 10 degrees, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. Remember, this is not E, it is delta, angle of deviation we are now plotting. So for 10 degrees, calculate angle of deviation, you will be getting some value, right? Now for that you will mark it. So let me consider like you have got some angle nearly 80 for 10 degrees. Similarly, when you take 20 degrees, you have got some value like nearly it is 60. And then you may get one value like 40 for 30 degrees. And then for 40, again, you may get it as 50. And you may get some other value for 50 degrees. You may get some other value like 70. You will plot those all points. And join these all points. Now, if you join these all points, what you will be getting? See here, you are getting a graph like this. Right? You'll be getting graph this way. And what is your what did you notice from this graph? It is observed that for less angle of incidence, angle of deviation is larger. It is decreasing up to certain value and beyond that it is going on increased. And this particular value, which is lowest, least value, this least value is nothing but called as angle of minimum deviation. So whenever this angle of minimum deviation is observed, that means if delta M is minimum, so this minimum deviation for minimum deviation, we get angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergent and R1 is equal to R2. These two will be obtained for this particular angle of minimum deviation. So angle of minimum deviation will be seen only when this condition is satisfied. I is equal to E and R1 is equal to R2. These things we are substituting in the derivation From there, we have got relation between relation for refractive index, which depends on angle of minimum deviation and angle of prism.